Hello, everybody, and thank you so much for being here today. I was actually able to get time with some of the hottest Meishan members in the US. The last few weeks have been tough because they've been interviewed in, I think, at least five other places. Is that right? Did I get that count right?
Something like that, yep.
Like that, yeah. Well, welcome. This is Mariell Marencic with me and Grace Marencic. And if you've been following their journey, they led the charge of the first All Meishan show class in the United States. So welcome and congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, so I just wanted to chat and just hear about your journey because we haven't always been met with the most open arms at some of the shows. And yeah, how about you? Did you find that getting your own class was an uphill climb? Tell me a little bit about what that was like.
Sure. So Grace has been in the clover bud program since she was five. So she started with poultry. So when she knew that she was going to be eight in the 4-H world, because you have to be eight by January of that year, she said, "Okay, let's do horse and let's do pig." And we were said, "Okay, sure, why not?" So I went into the brochure looking into the fair that was coming up, and it said, Duroc, Hampshire, blah blah blah, and then it said all other breed registered breeds. I said, okay, well, I think that's what we do. Well, I had to sign her up for 4-H, and so I started talking to some people, and they were like, "What do you mean a Meishan? What is that?" And I said, "Oh, it's a pig that we raise." I said, "We have quite a few on our farm, and she wants to show him." And right away it was like, "No." And I thought, "What do you mean no? I don't understand. It's a pig."
I love that.
And actually, what I don't think I realized, that there were some people that got wind of the no and pushed on the other side to help me. So
I
when
love it.
I got the email that said, "You'll have your own class," I went, "Oh, okay. Sure, great." And so that's really how it started. But we didn't know anything. We had no clue what we were doing.
So
All
this
we
was
just
your
thought was we were going to show a Meishan, like, what are we doing? There
right.
was so much after that that just fell into place, and we didn't realize how hot it was going to be at all. She just wanted to show a pig, and that's all we had. We
I
didn't
love
really
it.
think anything more to it.
So you guys aren't even show pig people, like you're not experienced in that. This was your first time out of the box, if you will, possibly.
Yes, we had no idea what we were doing.
Wow, you set the bar really
It was definitely interesting.
Grace, what did you win? Could you share with all of us what your ribbons were for the show? And you can even go beyond the Meishan because I know you were super successful all in a lot of areas.
Like a person. Well, you can, if you want to show, she has her ribbons here because
Yeah,
we're a
show
Meishan
us. I want
fan.
to see them.
So you hold them up like this, like that.
I got this one and
So
this.
that was her first, the first slash grand champion, Meishan, and that was Dorothy. That was her
Wow.
favorite pig. Dorothy and her, it was like seamless. It's kind of like when you find the perfect horse. They were perfect together. Nothing was going to stop them. That pig wasn't going to do anything that Grace didn't ask it to do. Now, because she had two pigs, you're allowed to take two, but she can't show two at the same time. So she had her friend Lillian show her other pig.
And she got
And
reserved
then she
champion.
got reserved. Very good, Grace. And that was
Sweet.
Elphaba.
Sweet, sweet. And then what was
And
the red
then
ribbon for it?
that was
Her
the, just the
second.
second place.
It's just a second.
I'm not sure why
Oh,
we
okay.
got two.
They went
Kind of came
together.
up.
Because maybe this says reserve champion to tell you that you got reserved,
Yeah,
and then
maybe
this is
that's
just
it.
second.
Yeah.
Yeah,
So,
well, congrats.
I was, when she was in the show ring, it's just kind of like when she's in the horse show ring, when she started first showing 4-H horses, I just wanted her to stay on. I didn't care if she placed. I didn't care if her hands were down. I just wanted her to stay in the saddle. So when she walked in there, it was the same thing. I just want you to go in and walk back out and be fine. She went in there. Now she won't. She'll, celiac, silly. She went in there like she was a pro. Like, mm-hmm. she was like, oh, this is no big deal. But she had formed that relationship. So it was kind of like just taking your dog for a walk. You were taking your pig for a walk.
Oh, that'd be fun.
So it was just like, it was so easy, but you could hear people talking. And of course, I'm sitting on the floor trying to get a million pictures. And, you know, and I said to my husband, you get pictures, I'll get video. And you could just hear everybody, like you could hear them saying. But at the same time, you could see the eyeballs. Like, why are we wasting our time doing this? Like, we all have to sit here and watch this. But what makes no sense is our placement didn't affect anybody else's because we had our own class.
Right.
I could understand if you put the pig in the all other breeds and maybe the Meishan beat, you know, whatever.
Won that class,
Yeah, I could understand some jealousy because that happens, but it never made any sense in why we were being such a hard time and and stuff like that.
I stayed on the saddle, even though my stirrup kept falling.
Oh, yes.
Oh, that's complicated.
Yeah, she was doing her horse show, and she placed, even though her stirrup fell apart while she was riding.
Oh, wow.
At districts.
Yeah. Let's talk to you. We'll sort of talk about that later.
Yeah.
But let's see, you had a turkey that did good, too. Is that right?
That one got reserve grand champion.
My favorite turkey. I was, like, the nicest turkey. No, that turkey.
And then she also placed...
went to, because I know you said the pigs had to,
the turkey went to, but we've done the turkey before. He's done the turkey since she was 5, so that was okay. The pigs were rough, but she did qualify for district, the next level for the horse, so then that's coming up in a couple weeks.
All right, congratulations. Your schedule is busy because I know you guys are coming to the conference too. That's not that far off.
And we have a lot more.
A lot more.
I hope it's the beginning of many, many, many more, for sure. So it's interesting. I hear that all the way through, you had maybe people that weren't so welcoming to the whole Meishan show ring thing, even at the fair, huh? Well, yes. Did you have some that were, like, for you, happy to see you there, or?
A lot?
Yeah.
I wouldn't say a lot, but you did. Like, she made some friends.
Yeah, more friends than.
Than you had done in the previous year. So we did meet a lot of families that were just genuinely interested. But then they also realized it was all about the kids. So they would ask questions and they would help Grace. So it got by the middle of the week. She really didn't need our help anymore. She had formed relationships with other kids. And she'd say, Mom, we're going down to the wash. You know, bay, my friends are helping me, and off they go. But at the same time, you know, she'd come over and say, like, these kids are glaring at me and they're making comments, you know, so then, you know, give a little pep talk and just hope it stops.
Yeah. It's tough being a leader sometimes, you know, when you're the first one to stick your neck out there. Not everybody is on your plan. So kudos to you both for sticking with it and staying the course there.
And I feel like there was one mother who said, you know, it didn't dawn on us, but said, thank you so much for bringing so much attention to the fair. She said, everyone that's walking into this barn just wants to see the pigs.
Really? The Meishan?
Yeah, that's all. They just wanted to see the Meishan. They're like, well, we heard it on the radio or we saw it on the news. Like, where's this pig?
Yeah.
And so that we would have people come up and talk to us and ask us a million questions, and so we got to meet some, you know, different people. And it was a lot of fun. You know, if we can just set aside some of the negativity, like, it would have been an absolutely fabulous week.
Yeah. Yeah. Now tell me, I know that's the Lebanon Fair. You know, I'm all the way down here in Georgia. Is that considered a state, a regional? What size is the fair?
It's a county. It's Lebanon area county. So I mean, it's, that fair is actually pretty hopping compared to some of the other ones.
Mm-hmm. It seemed large.
But I mean, I couldn't really give you a description of how big it is compared to other ones, but it's a nice fair. I mean, when they At the end of the night, they've got cars lined all the way up to the road, parking, going to all the different events. And they it's a lot of fun. They have the rodeo. They have tractor pulls. And
they have, like, they have, like, a race on Friday. Like, a big race, I think.
Well, who's racing?
Like, cars.
Oh, you mean like a demo derby?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Oh,
those are fun. Yeah.
Yeah.
The car girl in me loves that. So. Yeah. So, having gone through this experience, even it sounds like it was somewhat split on the positive or the negatives. Would you do it again? What's the plan?
I do it again.
I love that.
You would do it again because you had so much fun.
And I made lots of new friends. And that's, I guess, so just super fun.
It was super fun. Minus having to send Dorothy to the butcher.
Yeah. Yeah, no, that was tough.
You know, and
but I still have one.
You still have, yeah. But I'm not sure why that particularly was that hard, because they go out, the girls, they go out and play with who we call the meat pigs. Mm-hmm. That's what we call them that we know are going to butcher.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't, you know, the kids understand at the end of the day, that's where they're going. I'm not sure why this was so much harder.
Yeah.
Maybe it's, I can't answer that, why it was so much harder. And we'll be honest. You were only sad about Dorothy. What about Elphaba?
I was sad about her too.
Oh, you were sad about Elphaba too? She was a little cranky.
I know, but like when I was laying down with the moon and the girl, I'm just so sad.
You were sad.
It's hard. And, you know, when you're connected with them like that, you know, I think it makes it that much harder. There was sounds like a lot of emotion was tied to that week and those moments too.
And somebody had said to us, interestingly enough, had said, how many kids did you see cry? Because I admit I was reaching out to some of the parents that had already done this and everything. And I said, what am I supposed to do? Say, you know, this is new to us. And so we were sort of talking about it. And then they said, well, how many kids have you seen crying? And I was like, just like a handful out of, you know, all of them. And that's, they were explaining that the kids that are crying are the ones that put so much work into it. Wow. That at the end, they're like, they just lost their best friend that they spent every single day with.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, you could also see the kids who had done it before, but even the kids that had been done, you know, had done it years before, they were the ones crying there too.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't think it's going to become any easier.
No, it would be hard on my heart in that scenario. And I get the whole meat pig thing, you know, absolutely. So, well, all right. I know you guys are coming to the conference September. We leave September 11th. It's what, the 13th through the 15th. What kind of good stuff might you share there? What can people expect to see from the Marencics for your part of the conference? If those of you that may not know, they are one of our guest speakers for the event to share how the whole experience, I shall say.
We could show them how to make some of these things.
She wants to show the kids how, you know, I explained to her that, you know, a lot of kids are looking towards her to say, well, if Grace can do it, I can do it. You know, because she said to me last night, she gets nervous when people ask her questions. I said, no, you don't. I said,
I can't even talk in front of my class.
I said, you're going to do well, but I said, you need to remember that these kids are looking up to you. I mean, we received messages saying that their kids now want to go to the fair because they're seeing that Grace is doing it.
Wow.
So when we come, I plan to bring, you know, some slides of, you know, pictures, but also I'm putting together a picture book for Grace of everything that she did. And, you know, we can share a couple tricks and tips that we learned that we never knew about, like being here on the farm.
Mm-hmm.
But I'll tell you what, in a barn with 160 pigs, and you have the Meishan come out.
Yeah, it's just two Meishans, to us.
I feel like to us, we wanted to say, like, all right, everybody, move out the road. We're coming. Here we come. And they do. They just walk in there and they're like, what are y'all getting excited about? You're just going for a bath. Like, chill. Yeah. You know, they just move down the hallway. So
That's
we
great.
Have, you know, like those tricks and tips that we'd be happy to share. And if we do an open forum, we can just answer the questions to the best of our ability.
Right now on the itinerary, and it's not 100%, you guys are kicking us off Saturday morning, right behind an introduction from me, where we'll jump into the show ring and your experience. And it is definitely open to the audience. Our new PA system will be in next week so that we can do that, make sure that we can hear everybody. And absolutely, I thoroughly enjoyed talking to you, Mariell, during the experience. And I feel like you guys broke a glass ceiling for the Meishan Hall. It's just phenomenal what you were able to do. I'm grateful for those from the other side, as you said, that pushed for the class, because you both showed us that it can be done. And I look forward to hearing more from you and supporting you guys so much more down the road, because I think this is just the beginning.
And thank you. And you know, we had a very special family with us that have been getting Meishans for meat from us for a while, and they wanted to do it with us. So it was definitely a close-knit family there. They helped us every bit of the way, but they also said, we'll do it too. Like, okay, like, come on. So that's the type of family that they were. And everybody needs that. When you're introducing something different, you have to have somebody else with you that you can cry with and get angry with and everything so that it actually happens. Because honestly, I had no idea, and Grace didn't either, that this was going to happen.
I'd be sad if
she just wanted to show a pig.
Yeah.
I didn't have anybody to cry with.
Yeah. She cried with her friends. They laid in the pens together and all of them cried together. And that's what it's all about. And we need to continuously remind people it's about the kids, and that's the end of the story. We want them to have fun. We want them to think back when they're old and say, you know, oh, I remember that one time. Remember, you got a newspaper article. My husband and I never had animals. We didn't do 4-H. We don't have those memories, but they're awesome.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, Grace, I just want to share that it's okay to be nervous. I still get nervous when I speak, and you just do it anyway. You know, you just choose not to focus on that and look at what the results will be. So again, thank you guys for your time. Is there anything else that you'd like to share about your experience?
No.
You'll think about it. We've been every day thinking about the conference and all the things that we're going to say, we're going to do, we're going to see.
And all the stuff we're going to do.
Yeah. So we're very excited. And thank you for, you know, I'll be honest, between you and Wendy, you guys kept me sane, because, you know, I didn't know what to do. It was so brand new. I didn't know what to say to Grace when she would hear things. And so I owe a lot to you and Wendy for talking to me and saying all the right things to keep me down on the ledge, off the ledge. And that's what we have to do for each other. We won't make it.
Yeah. Yeah. You're very welcome. It's been an honor for me to be here with you on the journey. And again, I this won't be the first or last time. Well, it is the first, not the last time. Anyhow. So, all right. Well, I'm going to sign off. I've got to get this posted on the conference page and the YouTube page so that we can keep moving towards conference. The logo just came in yesterday, and it's really, really neat. So you guys will see that soon. And if I don't see you before, I'll see you at the conference in a few weeks. And thank you guys so very much for watching today. I'll see you next time.
Thanks, Laura. Bye-bye.
You're welcome. Bye. Okay.
There we go.
Did it stop recording? It is still recording.